Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to take you through one of the practical uses of Google Slides to build something like a virtual gallery walk or museum for you and your students. This is an activity I did with some fourth grade students here in New York State with part of our Native American curriculum, and I was just throwing artifacts in there. So if you are a history buff, a lot of things are wrong, but they're just for example. So stick with me. All right, here we go. So inside of this, what I would typically go through with students is what they're going to do first of all. So we're going to use some specific tools. We're going to use the format and style. We're going to talk about the Explore tool for research, and then also pictures, shapes, and links. So this is just the basic stuff. If you're familiar with this stuff, you can skip through it. Here's a basic 3D museum type thing that we're going to build really quickly. I'm going to show you how to do it, how to link it to other slides, and how to assign this to other students so that you can kind of do a virtual gallery walk with your students. So basically what this is, it's all built with shapes, with images, and with links. Each one of these things on the wall, if I go into present mode, is clickable. So if I were going through this with students and I click on, say, this wampum bell, so it takes me to a slide with information about that artifact, right? So each kid may have to find an artifact and then do a little report on it, or maybe it's a book report or whatever. And then you just go back, and so it takes you back into the room, and then you can look at this, you know, or this artifact, or the one over here. And you can work this a lot of different ways. If you have multiple rooms, you could use these side panels to move to the next room in the virtual gallery and then have things on the wall. So let me go ahead and get out of here, and I'll show you the basics of how it's built. So I'm going to skip down. You can see I have a bunch of slides open here on the left, and I'm going to skip down to this bottom one just to show you kind of how it works. But essentially, if I click in the middle, this is a square, okay? These are trapezoids on both sides, and then this is my background. So we need to be able to insert either an image in the background, a couple of shapes. We can make them look however we want. So the first thing that I like to do is to have kids go to change the background. I just right-clicked it, go to the background, and just choose an image. So they can use Google search, they can search for a texture, they can search for a specific image type. I'm gonna do one here on biodiversity in a separate video. Stick around on a similar application, but in a science classroom like mine, where this might make a little bit more sense to talk about different, you know, areas of the world, biomes or whatever. So you can use whatever it is that you're looking for that would fit in the background. So I basically just typed in wood panel. And so a lot of times you might have just sort of a wood panel in the background, or maybe it's your ceiling, maybe it's your floor. That's what you're thinking of. What do I want my ceiling and floor to be? It doesn't matter what you choose. It's all going to work the same way. So maybe you want to actually type in marble floor. So now I'm going to find a marble floor that will work for me. Actually, this doesn't look like marble, but I do kind of like it. So I'm going to insert this into the background and hit done. Don't add it to theme. You just want to add done. So there it's showing up as my floor and my ceiling. And that's kind of a problem, but not a big one. So now I'm going to insert up here an image. And the same deal, I'm going to look for an image through searching the web. So let's say that I just want to go over here to this, and I want to type in plaster ceiling. I don't know what's going to come up. Let's just try that. So this one right here is pretty boring, but who cares? We're going to insert it. Now, the thing that we need to know here when it creates this image is all those images that you're searching here in Google are going to be okay for students to use as far as copyright issues go. And I'm going to go ahead and stretch this out so that it meets the width, really is all I care about. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide it up so it's not covering my floor. I'm going to right click it, and I'm going to send it all the way to the back. Now it still layers on top of the background, because that's not an editable layer in the way that we're thinking of stacking things on top of each other. So now I have this, like, you know, marble floor or plaster ceiling starting to look pretty good. And I can go in and click on these shapes. So if I didn't have them there, this is what it's looking like. So these are trapezoids. I'll just go ahead and delete one for now. what I'm going to do is go up here to the shape tool, and I'm just going to grab a rectangle, and I'm going to draw this out probably about, I should align that up, about two-thirds, and whatever your wall color is that you want behind there, usually it's some neutral color, right? I'm going to slide that over until it tells me it's in the center. There we go. And I might want to shrink this down a little bit so I have room to put things on the side walls as well. So I'm going to snap that in there. And then because I have this trapezoid set up over here, I'm just going to hit Control C and Control V to paste. Now it's going to move it off screen, and that's okay because I just want to slide it, rotate it around 90 degrees and move it over. I'll move my stuff back over here. And really all you're trying to do, let me get this lined up where I want it, I'm way off, is to snap it in place so that it looks sort of like a three-dimensional perspective of a wall, but it's going to give you enough size to put things on there. So now if I wanted to add my first image to the wall like I have in my other place here, I would just go up here to insert image. So let's say your students are creating like a virtual zoo exhibit. Hey, let's try that. So I'm going to search the web, and let's say that I'm really interested in lemurs for some example, for some reason. So I have this lemur right there. I like this one. We'll hit insert, and we're going to put that right on the back wall. So let's say that I want to make this look, hey, it looks kind of like we're in some type of exhibit, but now the student has to create a slide that gives me information about the lemur. So what I'm going to do is go over to this side. I'm going to hit new slide. Now, it doesn't really matter how you originally set this up, but let's just say that I'm going to go with this one. I'm going to type in ringtail lemur. I'm not sure if it's ringtail or ringtailed. We'll find out in just a second. And I'm going to copy lemur. There's no E on there. Lemur. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, and I'll show you why. Down here in the lower right, there is an Explore tab. So if I click on that, it's actually going to give me, in just a second, some search terms. So I'm going to paste this in here. It is ring-tailed lemur. That's good to know. So I can go back and I can change that. So students are going to be able to find research, as I've got right here, web images or stuff in their own drive if they've done the research in advance. But if I go here to web, it's going to tell me a bunch of stuff. Now, I'm not going to encourage kids to copy paste, but maybe to find out, learn more on Google. And every time they do, it's going to insert where they got that from as well. So let's say I find my, you know, my information, and I'm done with my research. The other thing that's really pretty cool about this is if I drag, oh, I like this one. So let's drag this in here. Once it puts that image in my slide, you'll notice down here at the bottom, it's telling me where I got it from, and I did not get that where I wanted. So let me delete this text box and I'll drag this up. Okay, so right now it's kind of obnoxious in the way this is laying things out. But if I go back here to the Explore tab, it pops out some really cool layouts. So it's gonna take the image that I found, the title that I have in there, and give me some options to make this look way more professional than I might be able to do really quickly on my own. So I kind of like this one at the top. I'll click on that. Now I can go over here, put information in here about my lemur that I can find by just going back and pasting in my ring-tailed lemur, doing my research, and then putting it in here. But here's where the magic happens. On every slide, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a shape. It's going to be an arrow, and it's going to be the back button. So essentially, I'm just creating a little back button. I'm going to drag it out down here. It does not matter color, all that stuff. You can pick. Remember, don't make flashy trashy, right? Like, it does all these cool things, but it's not no information. So I always encourage students to get their information first and then to make it flashy, because we don't want flashy trashy. And now I'm going to use the exact same thing on these two slides to link them together. So I'm going to go back to this one. And so here's my ring-tailed lemur exhibit. I'm going to click on the picture and I'm going to go to insert. And down below here, I'm going to look for link. Once I link it, I'm looking for a slide in this presentation. I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom to find my ringtailed lemur slide. I'm going to click on that and hit apply. Now I'm going to go to my ringtailed lemur slide. I'm going to click on the arrow. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to insert a link, slides in this presentation. And I'm going to slide 8. So slide 8 is my basic one. I'm going to hit apply. And now let me just show you this by going to present. So when I present it, it looks a lot better because it removes all the other stuff. I have my ceiling, I have my walls. Of course, there's only one thing on there. I click on my lemur and it takes me to the page with information about the lemur. And I click on the arrow at the bottom and it's going to take me back. The one thing I want you to notice when I hover over the images is they're linked to where they came from. So again, if you want to teach kids about digital citizenship and crediting their sources, it's all going to be in there, but it just provides a vehicle for that conversation to happen. And the same is true of this image and any information that they drag in from the Explore tool right here. So you could quickly assign an animal or let kids pick one and then have them build just one slide. They could share that slide with you. You add it to the presentation and then go back and link all that stuff in there. So I'm just curious, like in your experience, what do you see that you could use this virtual thing for, like in a social studies and science and math and ELA and technology, whatever class it is that you teach? Or would you use this as a STEM project to integrate those things from maybe science and ELA or social studies and ELA, whatever it is? So it's really great tip or trick here. Stay tuned because I got another one coming up, a specific science example where I'm going to tie on this lemur in the next video. So I'll see you then.